Hey guys, Harsh here and welcome back to Technolobe. Now first of all, if you notice a difference in the setup, then that's because there is a difference. I moved this desk upstairs where I have an empty room and I'm going to convert it into my studio. So that's going to happen over the next couple of months, so stay tuned. I will be making a room tour, a desk setup and all those videos. That's why stay tuned. But today, I'm back over here to talk about the Poco F1. Yes, yet another video on the Poco F1, and yes, I'm still using this phone as my daily driver. Now, if you are a regular on the channel, then you might know that I've been using the Pixel Experience ROM with my Poco F1, and it has been working really, really well. In fact, I've made a separate video about the Pixel Experience ROM on Poco F1, and in case you missed that video, I'll drop a link to it in the I button and also in the description box below. Please go ahead and watch that video, you will definitely enjoy it. But today, we are going to focus all our energies on only one aspect, that is Google Camera application. Now obviously, you don't need to install a custom ROM to get Google Camera on your Poco F1. You just have to go ahead and download an APK and it will work because Camera to API is enabled on Poco F1. That's why I'll make sure to drop a link to the APK in the description box below. You can go ahead and instantly download the Google Camera application on your Poco F1. And it should work really, really well. Now that was enough about how to install Google Camera and all those things. Let's just get to the sample images and you can see for yourself how good the Google Camera app performs. Like for example, take this image. I shot this a couple of days ago and instantly my mind was blown. I shot this by using the night sight feature and the dynamic range that I got was excellent. Night sight clicks some incredible pictures in low lighting conditions. Like often when you click images in low lighting conditions, there is a lot of noise and you don't get that good of a dynamic range. But using Google Camera application, you get awesome dynamic range and the details are next level. So yeah, night sight is kind of mind-blowing and it's like magic. You get such good results and if you compare them to the stock camera application or any other camera application for that matter, they won't stand a chance. Now do make a note that night sight takes a couple of extra seconds to click the picture. So you have to hold the phone still and if you, move it or shake it, then the image might come blurry. So that's why if you want the best experience, I would suggest use a tripod with night sight. And it will work really well. Now this shot I did not use a tripod because my hand was pretty stable and that's why I got a pretty good shot. Now other than that, in normal daylighting conditions and artificial lighting conditions as well, the Google Camera application performs flawlessly. Like the HDR mode on this application is next level and I don't know how Google is making this application, but it's practically magic. So when you compare these images to the stock application doesn't stand a chance in terms of dynamic range, colors, and also in terms of the detail level. Like every time you click a picture from Google Camera application, you are going to notice that the detail is excellent, dynamic range is on point, the colors are very natural, and the saturation is on point as well. So overall, you get a very pleasing image to the eye, and you can directly upload the image to Instagram, and I'm pretty sure you will get a lot of likes because the Google Camera application performs so well. Also, one place where this application shines is in terms of portrait mode. You get awesome front portrait selfies, the edge detection is on point, the background blur is natural, and one advantage you have over here is that you can get both the images, the non-portrait as well as the portrait. So it saves both the images and you have your option. Like if you don't like the portrait image, you can immediately select the non-portrait image and you have that at your hand, which is kind of incredible and every application should have this feature. So overall, the Google Camera application combined with the Poco F1 is kind of like a dream combination and it's practically magic. So when you buy the Poco F1, I would highly recommend you to install Google Camera application because it takes the camera experience to the next level and you will have a great time with the Poco F1. So the fact that you can buy the Poco F1 at 21,000 rupees and then install Google Camera on it and get such good results makes this phone really compelling for the price point, and you can instantly go ahead and buy it and you can take my word for it. Now, obviously, the Poco F2 is just around the corner, and if you want to wait for that phone, then you can do that and you know, buy the Poco F2, which will have a better camera, and hopefully it will perform better with Google Camera application. But right now, as of this date, that is 10th January 2019, Poco F1 works really well with Google Camera application. I'm going to leave it there. Please make sure to check out the description box below, because there will be a link available to download Google Camera application for your Poco F1. So anyway, that's been it. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope that this video helped you out in some way or the other. And if it did, then make sure to smash that like button. Also, if you have any suggestions, comments, whatever, you can drop them in the comment section down below. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world to me. My name is Harsh Punjabi, and I'll see you guys in the next one.